Hi,
I'm Dr. Michelle Lee, a board-certified ophthalmologist, and today I'm going to go through the five most important emergency eye problems that may warrant an immediate trip to your eye doctor or even to the emergency room. The first eye problem that would require emergency attention is eye trauma, especially any possible penetrating eye injury. With any trauma to the eye, there is always a possibility of an opening of the eye, which we call a ruptured globe. Even if the vision is excellent, an eye that has been ruptured is at risk of permanent blindness due to infection. So even if you are not sure if the eye is open or not, it is important that if you have trauma to the eye, that this is looked into immediately. You would be surprised how many people have penetrating eye injuries that require emergency surgery. A chemical injury to the eye would also be an emergency. If you get harsh chemicals to your eye like ammonia and lye, you absolutely need to start flushing your eye with water or eye wash for a good 10 to 15 minutes within 15 seconds of injury to minimize permanent damage to the eye. You need to then seek emergency attention at a hospital where they will continue to wash out your eye until the pH of your eye is within normal range. After that, an ophthalmologist will need to evaluate your eye to see what damage has been done and decide if there is any emergent procedure that needs to be done. The reason why these steps are important is because if there is a chemical injury, we worry about damage and loss of cornea stem cells that differentiate the conjunctiva, or the white part of the eye, with the cornea, or the clear layer over the colored part of the eye. This problem, called limbal stem cell deficiency, is one of the most difficult eye conditions to treat. Another emergency eye condition would be a retinal detachment, or separation of the vascular wallpaper of the eye from the wall of the eye. This condition typically presents with a combination of flashing lights, like multiple camera lights going off, many new floaters, which look like black dots and shapes floating around your vision, or curtains, which are large areas in your visual field that are dark or hazy. If you might be having a retinal detachment, you should get your eye looked at as soon as possible. The best thing you can do is call your eye doctor so they can triage your symptoms, but if you do not have an eye doctor, you should go to the nearest emergency room or trauma center so that the on-call ophthalmologist can see what is going on with your eye. The sooner the retina is reattached, the better chance you will have to recover some vision. If you have a sudden headache around your eye, as well as blurry vision from the same eye, you might have angle closure glaucoma. Angle closure glaucoma, otherwise known as acute glaucoma, is when the colored part of the eye, or the iris, bulges forward to block the drainage system, which is located at the intersection of the iris and the cornea. This can be due to the anatomy of the eye, induced by some medications, like antidepressant medications, trauma, or due to a progressively growing cataract inside the eye. Acute angle closure glaucoma is an emergency because having a high pressure in the eye will eventually cause death of the optic nerve, the nerve which transmits information from the eye to the brain, and lead to permanent blindness if not treated. The initial treatment of angle closure glaucoma are eye drops to lower eye pressure, and the condition is fixed with a laser which is done to open up the drainage system. Corneal ulcers are another emergency eye condition and one that is near and dear to me as both a cornea specialist who actively treats corneal ulcers, as well as someone who has had a corneal ulcer in the past. A corneal ulcer is an infection on the cornea or the clear layer in the front of the eye, and every ulcer starts out with a scratch on the cornea or a corneal abrasion that gets infected. Risk factors for a corneal ulcer include overwearing and sleeping with contact lenses, certain eye diseases, recent eye surgery, trauma to the cornea, as well as certain underlying medical conditions which may predispose the eye to infections. Corneal ulcers and abrasions have similar symptoms of severe eye pain, tearing, and redness, but a corneal ulcer will look white, while it is hard to see a corneal abrasion without a microscope and a special dye that we use to stain the surface of the cornea. If you see a new white spot on the cornea or blurry vision along with eye pain, talk to your eye doctor as soon as possible to seek help. If you do not have an eye doctor, you must seek emergency care at the hospital to get cultures, to figure out what kind of infection you have, and to start treatment immediately. And last but not least, if you have any sudden symptoms like loss of vision, double vision, pain with eye movement, you need to go to the emergency room. These sudden symptoms may be a sign of a life-threatening problem like a stroke, bleeding behind the eye or in the brain, inflammation, or a bad infection. A quick diagnosis and initiation of treatment is the key to possibly saving your life. There are many other eye conditions and symptoms that would be considered an emergency, but these are the top five eye conditions and associated symptoms that would get me out of bed in the middle of the night when I am on trauma call. Also, if you do have any known eye issues or have had recent eye surgery, talk to your doctor about what symptoms you should be looking out for and how to reach your eye doctor if your eye is worsening. Have you ever experienced any of these eye conditions? Let me know in the comments below. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!